Let us see what happens next. One day, however, George unexpectedly acquires a new friend. Means he gets new friend. And next door neighbor, Annie. Annie's father, Eric, is a brilliant scientist and ever willing to answer all of George's questions. Eric has built a super intelligent computer named Cosmos. Cosmos is the name of the computer. Cosmos has incredible powers. What do you mean by incredible? Extraordinary, impossible to believe. It can literally open windows on the universe and take you to any planet. Can you imagine, students? Star, comet, and even to a black hole. And of course, Cosmos can also bring you back from there. However, Cosmos depends entirely on the information that is fed into it by people like Eric, who do the research and thinking that can make Cosmos work. Science can be used for a good cause, and a group of good scientists like Eric have vowed to use it for people's welfare. Welfare means the health and happiness of an individual or a group. Unfortunately, there is one odd, angry scientist who wants to use science for his own selfish motives. He is planning to steal Cosmos and all of Eric's research so that he can establish his own rule on another planet. It so happens that only George can do something to overcome the wicked plans of the nasty scientist. If you want to know what adventures he undertakes and what strategies, what plans he has to use to stop the power-hungry scientist, you have to read the novel George's Secret Key to the Universe. In this way, this introduction means this review creates curiosity in reading the book. The name of the book is George's Secret Key to the Universe. It tells us why should we read that particular book.